Hey all, today I want to quickly show you one way to set up a feedback loop in your DAW. I'm going to do this in Logic today, but everything I do here could be done in Pro Tools and Reaper, whatever DAW that you're using. This is just a little Casio drum beat I found on freesound.org. Let's look at our mixer. So the Casio beat is our audio track. It goes for its output to the stereo out. All right, let's hear it. Okay, pretty good. Once again, it goes to our out. We have a master control here, so there's nothing new here yet. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to send this to bus one. Okay, so I said I was going to send it to bus one, but it's important that I actually am not doing a send. I've set its output to be bus one, which is this aux track here. So this output now goes to this aux track. Now, where does the aux track go? Well, to the stereo out. So if I play this again, there's no change, save for the fact that things go out of here and into here. So the reason we're sending it to this bus, sending it to this aux track, is so now I can go to this and send it back into the aux track. If this terminology is challenging, I have another video that goes into the difference between sends, buses, and aux tracks. But let's play it, and I'm going to slowly turn up this. This one is a send. We're still hearing the output come out of the output. But now I have a send that sends where? Well, right back into the input of this track. This might be kind of loud. Don't worry. You're not going to damage anything within Logic, right? Because it'll clip its sound internally. The thing you just need to be careful about is to make sure that your volume is not too loud. Again, it's not going to be any louder than the loudest output from your DAW usually, but you want to make sure that, especially if you're wearing headphones, you keep that in mind. Let's hit play. Okay, not terribly interesting at the moment. Probably what's happening, I don't know for sure in Logic, but I'm going to guess that basically it gets delayed one sample, and so we get this sort of, I hesitate to call it a flanging effect, but that's kind of what it sounds like. Okay, so now this is going to be interesting once we add some audio effects in here that it can pass through the loop multiple times doing. I like to just put in something to get rid of sub audio, just helps me to not blow up here. We could add a more interesting EQ in just a second. I'm going to add, let's start with a delay. We'll do the tape delay. And then I'll come back to these settings in just a moment. The last thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to throw on a limiter. And this is just, once again, prevents things from blowing up here. So let's go to this tape delay. I'm going to turn down the feedback of the tape delay because we've already got it feeding back on the track itself. Now let's play this. Took a second for it to start because we're only listening to the wet here. Okay, let's turn up that wet. You could add the dry back in too, but maybe we'll just listen to the wet for now. Let's start it feeding back. One of the neat things worth understanding in Logic is if you do a gain, you can invert the phase with this. And inverting the phase on your feedback loops might be an effective thing to do. Not in love with that ring shifter. I could change that to a reverb. Now, if I want a more mundane effect that I actually use in a mix or something, I might go back to the dry there. I'm keeping my limiter at the bottom here after all the other things I've done because I want to make sure that I'm not blowing things up. Oh, here's a fun one, pitch shifter. I mean, heck, at this point, we don't even need the original, right? I'm gonna delete that drum beat from it. All right, so I've got nothing. But now we're just in the loop. Oh no, I'm gonna lose things. I better ride my gain a little bit. So now I just have this feedback loop going. There's no input coming off of my Casio beat track. I could put that back if I wanted to, but all that happens is sound goes through here. We get to hear it at that stereo out, but we also have a send that sends it back in at the top, and we keep looping through this forever. We could add some feedback into here too if we wanted to. Give us some tape effects in there. We're sitting around there. We could, we can always make some more adjustments. Maybe we won't mess with the EQ too much. I start to lose my loop. I can crank the gain, see if I can get it back. Oop, went too far. Let me bring down the output of here. So, whether you want a more subtle effect on a drum track, or just want to do some no input mixing within your DAW, try different effects. This is pretty easy. Watch the levels coming out of your headphones and have some fun. That's all I got for today. See you next time.